It's often said in our secular society that people have the right to determine morality for themselves. This is what happens when that view is taken to its logical conclusion. The clip you're about to hear is Dr. Greg Bahnsen, a Christian apologist and philosopher, who is giving a lecture at Arizona State University. And notice what happens when somebody tries to take their subjective moral opinion and place it upon Dr. Bahnsen.
Okay, how about if we say two more questions?
Then two more, and then we'll go.
Okay. Thanks for your patience tonight in coming out. Well, we got two already. Discrimination rights. Okay, here, and then we'll be done.
I'm a pagan, and I live my life by the book and reading to that, which is Antoine Manuel Calvillo. As long as you're harming nobody else, you're free to do whatever you want.
Why am I not allowed to harm other people?
Because that is the only sin that there is. Whenever you do not harm somebody,
who says that you
harm their freedom?
Well, so what? Who says that's a sin? Why shouldn't I harm other people?
It doesn't have to be told by anybody. To live in a civilization, you have to have that law.
Okay, so what if I don't want to live in a civilization? Or what if I want everybody else?
No, one at a time, you guys.
You have an advantage over me here.
Then you can go live on an island by yourself, and you can't go live. No,
well,
you're living with at least one other person.
No, you're not hearing my challenge here. What I'm saying is, you don't have the right to tell me to go live on an island. And if I want to harm you, I'm going to harm you. That's what your world you grant. I don't have to believe that as a Christian. I won't harm you because I have another ethic. So when you say, you're a pagan, and this is the one sin that everybody has to recognize, I'm saying, hey, pagan, why should anybody recognize even that sin? On what basis? On your sake, bro?
Does anybody recognize any of your sins?
Well, I don't think anybody should recognize them because I said so. Only if God has revealed himself, I said if God has revealed himself, if he has revealed himself in the scriptures and I've properly interpreted them and so forth, then that goes beyond our personal choices. But I would never say to anybody, even when I preach in a Christian church, don't do this because I say so. But I put it back in your face. If you tell me not to harm you and there's no God that you're appealing to, I say, why should I listen to you? It's your word against mine. That's different strokes for different
groups. Well, you claim that the Bible is the word of God, is your word against mine, or that word against mine.
No, as I said,
it's just a book. You know, anybody could have written it. You know, anybody, if somebody
that
wrote
is a
book and it's found thousands of years
ago, that's right, that is one hypothesis.
That doesn't mean that it's the truth.
No, and I haven't said that it is just because I said that it is. I said, in answer to this question here, it would take a while. We'd have to go into looking at other religions. We'd have to look at all the objections against the Bible, whatever. The Bible is not the Word of God because I came here tonight and said, I believe the Bible is the Word of God. What I'm saying is, I'm ready to defend that philosophically, historically, logically, whatever. Maybe I will, maybe I won't persuade you, but I am not, don't take me wrong, I am not saying you have to believe it because I said so. But you told me that I have to believe I shouldn't harm other people because you said so. And all I'm saying is, friend, you don't have any authority to tell me not to hurt other people.
I'm not saying this because I say so. I'm saying it because that's the only way humans can live together.
Okay, so maybe they can't live together. Why can't I? Well, tell me why I shouldn't bite the bullet and just say, okay, as far as I'm concerned, I've got the nudity and everybody else is going down before me. I don't care if we live together. Now, I think that is reprehensible as a Christian. What I want to know is, when you say it's not based on your say-so, what is it based on then? We can't live together
anymore? It's based on logic.
No, it's not based on logic. I assure you of that. I'm showing, here's what your logic tells me. If I'm under obligation because you say so, I'm saying my say-so is as great as yours, and so I'm going to shoot. And you say, but you'll destroy society. And I'll say, okay, I'll destroy society. Now, where's your logic in that? Logic is not being violated. If anything, I'm being ruthless and maybe a little rude to you, and I apologize for that, because I'm being so logical with you. I say, okay, I'll run with your worldview, and when it runs, it's right into the ground. Last question.
I'm an evolutionist.